Last Sunday is that we talked about a place called hell. It's not a good thing. I even wrote in my notes, the terrible fact is that hell exists. And it is a terrible fact. It's not something that we enjoy lifting up or talking about, but it is a fact from the scriptures. We showed last week the Bible says it's a real place. It is a real place where people will go. We also said last week that there's nothing that we can go through on this earth that would compare to that. I've had people say, well, I've gone through, and they'll maybe use a term, you know, I've gone through this, and it's like, well, you know, it's not. Hell is a bad place. It's a destructive place. There's nothing that we can compare to it, and there's nothing that will compare to that place. And we went over these things last week, but I wanted to show you this week, just for a few moments, that our Savior, Jesus Christ, suffered on the cross to pay for our sins for one reason. That was for souls to be saved. So Jesus suffered so that souls could be saved. Isn't that awesome, everybody?
Yeah.
About being saved, I remember, I tell my kids this story all the time, but I remember when I think I was in ninth grade, we went to a park called Turkey Run Park. Celeste, have you ever been to Turkey Run Park? Have you? April has. I remember I was in ninth grade, and our youth group went to Turkey Run Park. It was an awesome park. And there was a river that ran right through the middle of the park. It was a very fast flowing river. I mean, not just a little bit slow. I mean, it was moving down the line. And I remember we were doing a hike, and we had to go over all this stuff. It was a really interesting hike. And I remember we got by the river, and a girl that was in our group fell into the water. And she was drowning. The water was going over her, and she was drowning. And, you know, I'm not trying to brag about her or anything, but I pulled her out of the water, and it seriously, it saved her life. I know her name was Stephanie. I know her life too. But she was literally drowning. We were in ninth grade. But just to say this, that when somebody gets saved, it's the same concept. If I don't get saved, if I don't get rescued, so, I do, but thank you so much. But I forgot where I'm at now, I gotta start over.
Give you one warning off.
Start all over again. But Jesus,
Jesus suffered for souls to be saved. And salvation, either saving somebody out of water, it's the same concept. I'm saving someone from a place called hell. That's what salvation is. You are witnessing somebody's being saved. That's the term that we use. If Jesus' suffering was not for a cause, it was all for naught, or it was worthless. If some eternal, infinite good did not come from Jesus' sufferings, it was worthless. I'll put it this way. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah, by his stripes, anybody know the rest of that scripture?
We are healed.
You got it. By his stripes, we are healed. Jesus' number one purpose was to save people. Now look, Jesus gave people food. Jesus gave people water. Jesus healed sick people. He healed infirmities. He made people, the Bible calls it, whole again. He cast out demons. Jesus preached love. Jesus preached love your enemies. Jesus preached love your neighbor. He did preach all these things, but the main purpose, the thrust of Christ's coming, the purpose of his coming was to save people from their sins. And he grew up in Tennessee, and as his mother was full-blooded Cherokee during the Depression, his father died, and at 8 years old, he had to provide for his own family. Didn't have the money to do that. At 8 years old, he had to go and, I don't know how to say this, but he went and stole potatoes and food out of other people's yards and gardens so that they didn't have food to eat. So they didn't die. Starved to death. My grandfather grew up in that kind of lifestyle and did pretty well for himself, but he became a heavy alcoholic. I mean a strong alcoholic. I mean just to come home and drink a cases of beer every night would be drunk. My mom would ask me, could you stop? She poured his alcohol down the sink. I've heard all these stories. And she would ask him to quit, and they would all try to get him to quit. And for years, everybody tried to quit this to him. He wasn't a Christian, wasn't a believer. My mom, the family, and my grandmother would come to church together, and he wouldn't go. Well, you know, one time, my uncle was a little boy, about 5 or 6 years old. He crawled up into his dad's lap. And he said, "Dad, would you go to church with us? Would you go to church with us?" And my grandfather told his little boy, I don't know, 5 or 6 years old, "I'll go with you." And he went to church with the whole family that day. He didn't wear his coverall. He always wore coveralls every day, Tennessee. And he put his suit on, went to church, and he got saved that day in the Baptist church. Amen. He asked the Lord to be his personal Savior. And he changed his life. Amen. He gave it up, that alcohol, got saved, got baptized, became a deacon in that church. Amen. And God used him in a great way. Amen. Took him many years, though. Took a lot of going through to get to that point. But that's an awesome story. God's what we would call God's amazing grace.
That's right.
If I had the time tonight, I could go through our church and I could have most of you would have an amazing testimony. Would you all agree with me on that? About how God saved you. Wouldn't you agree? We have a wonderful Savior. And it's wonderful to see the differences of lives changed and heart changed because of what God, what Jesus Christ did for us on the cross and how so many have been saved. Don't ever become confounded or confused about salvation or about witnessing or being one who would give the gospel. God wants you to share the gift of salvation. You say, "Well, I'm not good at it." Well, welcome to the club. I'm not good at it either. I'm not good at being a witness as I should be. I'm not as good at talking about the gospel as I feel like I should be. I see a lot of people are better than me. I go so many people in our church. Excuse me. I go so many people in our church, and I feel like a beginner because they do so well at it. But you know what? I'm me, and God's going to use me the way He wants. Is that right?
Amen.
And
like these ladies that go to the restaurant and let all the waitresses to the Lord. They're all saved now, you know. But it's our calling, as a Christian to share with others the salvation that Jesus Christ so freely gave to us. You say, Pastor, how do I do it? Well, just do your best. We have these